is Dr. Taco here, back from another hiatus, I guess you want to call it. Just being busy, honestly, just way too busy. Anyways, we're here on X-Mage with some more Magic stuff. Kind of been what's eating up most of my time lately, doing Magic and other stuff. Just really been all around busy with life. Anyways, this is a little brew that I've been working on, and by working on, I mean I put it together and played like one match with it, and that's pretty much it. But the idea was to just hand disruption, like lots of hand disruption. It's kind of been changing. I had much more hand disruption in the original the original list, but they were kind of dead draws after a while, because by turn 3 or 4 I can almost have somebody empty handed, which is really nice. It works really good against the Healy combo, unless they can like repeatedly top deck their answers, but I mean that's why we have the Murders and the Grasp of Darkness, take care of that kind of stuff, the Authority of the Councils for that, also to slow down Mardu. Mardu can be a bit of a problem as well. And then our win cons here, you know, the Reality Smasher and Thought Not Seer, they're very, very difficult to deal with. Reality Smasher is almost impossible to deal with if your opponent's already empty-handed. They basically have to draw away to draw more spells to draw into, you know, draw into their removal. So yeah, he's just stupid good when your opponent's empty-handed, and the Thought Not Seer obviously helps them get empty-handed, and it's a 4/4 to boot, which is good. Yanni's Expertise, I threw it in there with a Board Wiper. I had Flame Tendrils, but it doesn't hit enough stuff mainboard for me to justify it. Some rogue decks, you know. It's good against Mardu, but that's about it, so that's why I kind of took it out and moved that to the sideboard and put in the Yanni's Expertise. Now this Come to Temptation for instant card draw. Mind Rot, which isn't great, but it once, you know, turn 3 or 4, if you can get your opponent down to 2 cards in hand, it's just okay when you're empty-handed. Murder, because it's Murder. The Gifted Aetherborn, it helps slow down the aggro a bit, too. Worst case scenario, you trade out for him, you gain 2 life and kill their thing. What else do we have? Harsh Scrutiny, obviously. Fatal Push, because it's Fatal Push. I originally had 4, and then cut down to 3, and then 2. Authority, again, I already explained that. Transgress the Mind, good against Sealy combo and Mardu vehicles to rip their unlicensed disintegrations out of hand before you play a Thought Not Seer or Reality Smasher, as well as other stuff. And then the sideboard we have the other two Fatal Pushes if we're playing against Mardu. Anguish Unmaking, that's also for Mardu and Saheeli, you know, the main two decks, and also the Tower decks if you happen to come across one of those. Flame Tendrils, obviously, for Mardu. Liliana, just swap out the creatures. And then bring in Planeswalkers instead, move to Planeswalker control as opposed to creature control. I would probably bring out the Gifted Aetherborns and the Thought Not Seers for the Lilies and the Gideons. And then Ruinous Path is also for Mardu and the Liliana, or not Liliana, sorry, Mardu and the Saheeli decks. So with that, we're going to try and jump into a game here and see what we can do. Alright, we found a match. Get out of here. Get out of here. There we go. Okay, let's see here, make sure, yeah, okay. Ooh, okay, this is an interesting hand. I can play the turn 1 Authority, the Murder, Gifted Aetherborn. I don't have hand disruption is the problem, but I don't know what we're playing against, so this might be really good. I'm gonna go ahead and keep it just because I have the turn 1 Authority that, you know, completely shuts down Saheeli, helps slow down Mardu. So we're gonna go with that and see if that's good enough to get us there. Let's see, yeah, turn on Authority, and go ahead, opponent. Let's see how fast we can figure out what they're playing. Okay, they're blue-black control, Esper, Grixis, so many things they could be playing. That's good. Unfortunately, we don't have another play after that, because we use our energy for the white. Yeah, with having to have the colorless mana for the Thoughtless Seers and the Reality Smashers, smashing some reality. Okay, they're on Esper. I don't know if that means they're Esper control, or we're gonna see. Horribly Awry incoming? Yep, called it. Yep, Esper control. Okay. That's fine. That kind of sucks that we kept a hand that we did then. We got punished for keeping a hand that would have been good against aggro, because I don't think they're aggro. They're not aggro at all if they have a Horribly Awry, so we might be in trouble here. Hopefully they don't have a second Horribly Awry, because I'm going to throw down this Thought Not Seer. Another Gifted Aetherborn. I could try and draw out the second Horribly Awry this turn and see what happens. Yeah, I'm going to see if I can do that. Come on, there we go. Do they have another? Okay, they don't have another one. That's good. Hopefully we can get some damage in with him before he dies. But considering they're in black, they're probably, you know, they probably have a fatal push in hand and they're just going to wait till we attack or play something else. But we are going to attack with Gifted Aetherborn before we try and Thought Nausea, to try and draw out, try and get them to tap down as much mana as we can. Okay, they got the Aether Hub.
Got it.
Yep, there's the push. I'm surprised they didn't wait to do that on our turn. Now I feel really uneasy about throwing out a Thought Not Seer. But they won't have... yeah, I think I just gotta go for it. Disallow, okay. Well, the good news is that they don't have mana for Gearhulk next turn, but I think if they do have a Gearhulk, I think I have to not play anything next turn or they'll murder. Well, no, maybe. I can't afford the Rinse Out and the more removal, but they won't Gearhulk until the end of our turn. And probably at this point they're gonna flashback anticipate. This is a rough choice. We're just gonna try it. We gotta go for it. They probably have another counterspell in hand. Or not? God, if they don't, that would be the greatest. Holy crap, they don't. Oh. They can Sorin next turn. No, they can't Sorin next turn, but they can Glimmer. They could have Glimmered in response, I don't know, but then we take the Sorin. Ah, man, that Sorin is going to be pain in the butt, but I think we have to take the Glimmer. I just think we have to take the Glimmer. So they have two lands and a Sorin in hand. Sweet. If they draw an untapped land, they can Sorin, which is bad. They drew an untapped land. Shoot. That's really bad. I assume he's going to minus four him to kill our... Yep, yeah, okay, he's going to kill our Thought Not Seer. That really sucks. Yeah, they get to draw a card off it. Man, okay, well, womp womp. Oh, yes. That's really bad. We're probably in trouble here. I can at least scry. Come on. Man, drawing a Reality Smasher there would have been the nuts. Oh, there we go. Okay, we're okay, though. To the bottom. Whew, okay, well, we got the Gearhulk out of hand, at least. That's something. I mean, we could have murdered it, but now we at least can save our murder for the second Gearhulk that we know is coming. Yeah, what do they flip? Grasp. Okay, well, we know they have a Grasp now, so we shouldn't be playing any Thought Not Seers. Come on, Reality Smasher. They have no counters in hand. They could have just drew one, actually. Alright, come on. Smash some Reality. This is basically peek at opponent's hand, scry one. That's how I'm seeing this. I don't care if they have creatures in hand. So they have Grasp and an Island. Yeah, I gotta bottom that. We're gonna die to Sorin here, not after too long, unless we can pull some creatures. Well, at least game two, I know now that I can take out all the fatal pushes. Probably take out the Grasp of Darkness. Probably keep in the murders for the Gearhulks. Fumigate. Okay, cool. That sucks. We're in a lot of trouble. We are in a lot of trouble. Now, should I murder this? Or just take the two. I think we just take the two for... Do I take the two or do I murder it? Because he has another one. I just take it for now. If we can draw our fatal pushes, that would be nice. Come on, Reality Smasher. That's not a Reality Smasher. I think we're going to lose this game. We got punished really bad for our you know, the gamble on the draw on our hand. I chose poorly. Man, did not expect to be going up against a control deck. Oh, there's a Gearhulk. Sweet. I think we're pretty much dead here. Yeah, there. Well, let's wait and see. No, even if we top deck a Reality Smasher, you can just flash in Gearhulk and kill it. Yeah, that's game. Okay. So, yeah, get out of here. We want to keep the Transgress, take out Grasp. Let's bring in the Planeswalker plan. Come on. Bring in that. Take out Yhenny's. Probably take out. I already took out the Grasp. Do I want to take out the Fatal Pushes? Well, I definitely want to take out the Aether, the Gifted Aetherborns. And take out Authority. That doesn't hit. Yeah, I think bring in. Yeah, keep some of the Aetherborns. Definitely bring in all the Planeswalkers and the Anguish of Makings and the Ruinous Path. Where did the Ruinous Path go? Where are those at? Oh, they're there. Okay. I was like, geez, where'd I put those? Yeah, I think we run it back like this.
Your game has started.
Okay, let's see. We have not a good hand at all. No disruption. Can't cast anything. No disruption, but I think we have to keep that. Just because I don't want to go down to five. Like, I have things I can play. That's not an issue. I think we keep that top. Okay. Okay. He mulled down to five. All right. We're good. We should be good. Oh, okay. Hopefully this game goes better. But then the issue is we're gonna be on the play. Gifts of Aetherborn off the top. Oh wait, no, we scry. Ignore that. Totally forgot that we scryed, that we left that on top. You know, because that's a thing. Okay, so they're probably holding up. Blah, 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 blah. Horribly awry mana. Yeah, because all our creatures that they saw were four drop or less. Let's see if they counter this. Sweet. Oh, Gideon. Balls. Oh, no, I can play Gideon. I'm probably going to run him out into straight into a counter. We got to go for it. I gotta go for it. Like, if he resolves, that's just the nuts. I mean, I can't not go for it. There's not really gonna be a better time to go for it. Here comes nothing. What? Well, Gideon's stupid. Gideon wins game. Gideon beat down, best beat down. Grasp. Okay. Cool. You killed my knight ally. Good for you. I are confused. Well, let's throw a Reality Smasher out there and see what happens. Counter? No counter? Man, you are in for like the world of hurtest. Just, oh my gosh. Well, that seems good. Just 10 damage on turn 5. And that's how we planned it. It almost makes me want to put the Gideons in the main board just because it's so good, but that's not the point of the deck. I don't want to just throw good cards in because they're good. I can throw them in the sideboard, that's fine. Oh, they have their own Gideon, cool. Well, he's gonna die. Make a knight ally, cool. He's still gonna die. Should have held up the counter, bro. Okay. Oh, and yep, just win there. Sweet. Well, they know we're on the Planeswalker plan now. I think we have to run it back. Yeah, I think we just run it back. That was sweet. That was a good play. That was good. I mean, we got the nuts of variance right there, that they had no counters, because if they had countered our Gideon, we would have been in a lot of trouble. Hopefully, the next game is a bit, hopefully the games aren't so one-sided. Didn't it seem like the first game was obviously our fault for being one-sided, that I kept a bad hand. It would have been good against aggro, but it wasn't aggro, so it was just like, oh, well, I got a couple lands and that's about it. Second game, we just ran him over. I mean, we got the nut draw, and the fact that they have a counter for the Gideon was really good. Are they still sideboarding? I hope they're still sideboarding. Where's our match at?
Your game has started.
Cool. No hand disruption again. Well, I mean, beyond the thought not, but we have the path. We know what their game is. Yeah. We'll try it. We'll try it. We're on the draw, so. Choked Estuary. Come on. Top. Aww. Actually, that's not bad. That's not bad at all. So we have the double Thought Knot. We can hit him back-to-back turns with that. The only bad thing about Thought Knot is if they kill it after it hits the battlefield. I mean, you still get to see their hand, which is cool, but you know. So I don't know if they took out the Horribly Rise or not. I'm just sitting here on a Fatal Push and a Ruinous Path. I really don't need to draw. Okay, we're gonna have 5 lands, 2 of every color. We don't need to draw anymore. Oh, that's a cool island. Wow, more lands. Well, swamp and pass. Land, go magic, best magic, right? I don't know if you can hear the screaming in the background, but that's just the TV. Don't worry about that. That is just a YouTuber playing Finding Bigfoot, which ooh, they missed their land drop. Something we're not doing. So, well, I threw down. Okay, well, I should have went with the Crumbling Vestige. Yeah, like she just screamed there. You probably heard it. Oh, that is a hand of good stuffs. Okay, so they have no counters in hand, just no counters, but double grasp. Keep that top. Okay, now that got really loud, so I'm gonna go turn that down. I will be right back. Alright, sorry about that. Hopefully the microphone wasn't picking that up. But I just like to have a little bit of noise in the background. And, okay. Well, there you go. that's kind of the biggest issue with Esper right now, I think. There's just so much good stuff, but it's so expensive, and the mana base isn't great and all that kind of stuff. Technically, I'm 3 color, which I could probably find some better lands to swap, but man, if Caves of Koilos was in standard again, that'd be so good. Pain lands are best lands. Not really, but that would be really good. Anyway, so that's the deck. Hope you guys liked it. I will be playing some more matches. I'm kind of just going to do one match per video for now. I might make a series out of it. If you like this deck, go ahead. I've been playing 4-color Saheeli in a Teemer Tower deck, and I got tons of decks here. Tons of spicy decks, like this one. This one's really fun. People don't expect this one. You see the Ceramos, and you're thinking, all right, well, when's the Aetherflux Reservoir coming out? And you throw this thing down, and they're just like, what are you doing? Like, what is that card? Well, it's really good, because you can just ping your opponent down slowly but surely. Just, you know, every time you throw down a Cheerio, it's just one damage. You can kill their creatures and stuff like that. And then the Dispel, obviously, to try and protect the Ceram, because, you know, he's kind of your main card draw engine. Sigarda's Aid is also nuts. Like, just nuts in this deck. especially if it's SRAM on the field, when they go to attack, you can surprise them with flashing in a Stitcher's Graft and that. It's a super fun deck, but it's like, it can be really frustrating to play as well. Sideboard, you know, for Saheeli, protect SRAM, also protect SRAM, and then the stuff for Mardu and that kind of stuff, that's also for Saheeli. Kind of. Like, if they turn three, throw Saheeli down and tap out for it, then you have that in hand, you can just blast Saheeli down. Oh, no, that still doesn't work. Never mind, I don't know. That's for Mardu. Or aggro. I can't remember. It's been a while since I played the deck. Kozilek's Return is definitely for Mardu. Where is that going, though? Yes, this deck is fun. What else we got? And that one's not good. Anyway, four-color tower deck. Is this my Abzan legendary deck? This deck is so much fun. I know it looks like it's all over the place. So the main purpose of the deck is to get your legendaries out with all these Lancers. We'll be right back. we don't generate that much energy. We don't generate that much energy. I think I want to throw two Talias in the main board. Get a little bit more early aggression out. And then two Hydras seems fine. Does it though? Does it? Let's see. What else can we do? What else can we do? Murder would be nice. Murder would be good. Oh, Fatal Push. Wow. Yeah, two Fatal Push main board. That's how long it's been. Like, this was way... This was before Aether Revolt, obviously. This was before Aether Revolt was spoiled. This was before the Looter Scooter bans and Emrakul bans. And poor Reflector Mage killing the Panharmonicon deck that was so much fun. So I can remove a natural state and throw another Fatal Push in the sideboard. That seems like it's gonna get about, that's about as good as it's gonna get for now. So that's the deck that we just completely changed. man, I think I can almost do this too. I only have three Gideons, so I tend to only play with three. Plus four of that card. Like, yeah, he's. It's Gideon. You should run four. I just don't like to run four of a legendary or, you know, that kind of card. So, that's just how I am. But, yeah, so that's this deck. Completely went on a tangent there, talking about decks. Yeah, here's the rest of them. Artifact Control. I think that was a Grixis. That was a Grixis control deck that somebody on Reddit posted, and then I kind of changed up some stuff and all that good stuff. Mono Blue Eldrazi is fun. That's the discard deck, the hand disruption we were playing. The Fire Weaver, always fun. Fire Weaver with Mechanized Production, just a straight Mechanized Production deck. Mono Blue Control. Oh man, this deck is so fun. It's not Mono Blue anymore. About that. I could probably just swap these into the main board. They don't count as islands though for Engulf, which is kind of big for the deck. We'll see. Mono blue, but with red in the sideboard. Cause Fever Visions is just such a good card. Anyways, that's a super fun deck. I don't think that's... I made a budget version of it. Yes, here's the budget version of it. This is what I was playing at my FNM, which I have changed up, so I'll have to do that. I'm gonna have to play this deck. This deck's just way too much fun. And yes, I have white Borderlands for Tilt Factor. Always. Always, always, always. Anyways, I gotta stop here because I'm just gonna keep going and rambling and ranting. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you want me to play a deck, send me a deck list. I will try. I play an X-Mage because I can't afford to play Paper Magic and MTGO, but I might start getting into MTGO. I just don't have a lot of extra funds to put into that. I build so many decks that it's very hard for me. It would be very hard for me to do that, to maintain that. And I've spent a lot of money on Paper Magic, as you can tell. You know, I have four Colossus of Healy, Teemer Tower, just a bunch of... I just like to buy cards. I have that collector in me, so, like, I don't sell my cards to buy other cards. I just keep all my cards and keep adding to my collection. So I literally have stacks on stacks of just Magic cards sitting around that my wife keeps telling me I need to clean up, which I probably should do. But then I lose them. I don't know where they go. I hide them for some reason. Anyways, so I'm going to get going. Tell me what you think. Like, comment, subscribe. It helps me out so very much. And I'll talk to you guys later. See you.